neighbor. I will dance this morning like never before. You see, this place is your stage. Come on. Amen.
Everything that is on, I will. I will. I will. I will. Yeah. let's clap for the choir. Today, God is set to do something great in our midst. Amen. Can I give amen to that?
Amen.
I can assure you one thing here today is that you will not go back the same way you are coming. I want you to be in the mood because the Holy Spirit is going to move in a way that you have never experienced. I'm not just saying it to move you, to make you feel good. I'm saying it because I know, I'm confident that God is going to touch you and you will not remain the same in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
I'm saying it because I have a confidence that my Father in the Lord, Daddy E.A. Adeboye, he has proclaimed that this month is a month of victory.
Yeah.
He has proclaimed that we should wait and fast. And as many that are diligently trust and obey, and they have been waiting, I tell you from the throne of grace, your waiting will not be in vain.
Yeah.
I say your waiting will not be in vain.
Yeah.
That fasting, that cry, that you are crying to God secretly, I say, my Father, in this month of November, please remember me. I have come to announce to you that God will answer you.
Yeah.
My ministers, please, I want you to bring the prayer upon that we had a covenant with God at the beginning of the month of November that I asked them to pray, to write. Please bring it, because we're going to pray on those prayer points today. And as we pray, God will answer us in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Shall we rise up? Excellent is your name, oh God. How excellent, how excellent is your name, oh God. How excellent.
Thank you.
two hands to heaven. Please, I want you to please just listen to God. Don't listen to me. Don't look at me. I'm nothing. I can do nothing. But I have come to you in the name that is higher than any other name. As he said it, will he not do it? As he promised you, will he not fulfill it? That is the God that I brought to you this morning. Raise your two hands to heaven. Not to me, but to God. And tell him your desire. And say, my Father, don't pass me by. This is my cry. This is why I'm here today. Oh God, I surrender all unto you. Remember me, oh God. Remember me, oh God. Today is a day that God will remember someone here. God is said to do something. Please don't look at me, but focus unto God and say, my Father, I raise my two hands for you. Remember me. Remember my household. Remember me. Take me to my next level. Change my situation. Your servant has said that you are going to visit people. Please visit me, oh God, in this land of UAE. Take me to my next level. Remember my household. Remember my children. Remember me, oh God. Change my destiny for better. Change my destiny for better. Brother, make sure you are praying. My sister, what are you doing? Make sure you are crying to God. Oh God, please remember me. Remember me, Lord. Remember me, my maker. Send my destiny helper. The year is going to an end. Send my destiny helper. Wherever they are, let them locate me. Let them favor me. Let them help me. Help me, oh God. Connect me to that man. Connect me to that woman that will change my situation. That will make my life better. Brother, pray. This is our time of fasting and prayer. This is our season of crying to God. That is why you are here. Pray with all of your heart. Oh God, remember me. My Savior, remember me. This month is about to finish. I don't want to finish in this way. I want to finish on a higher ground. I want to get that contract. I want to get that job. I want you to bless my husband. I want you to bless my wife. I want you to bless my business. I want you to change my destiny. Brother, make sure you are praying. God is passing by. The Holy Spirit is here. God is here. I don't care about your problem. I don't care about your situation. I have brought to you the name that is higher than any other name. That name Jesus. That name Jesus. That name Jesus. The name that every knee will bow. At that mention of that name, every knee must bow. Every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord. Call upon that name, my brother. My brother, I beg you, call upon that name. That name Jesus. My sister, call upon that name. That name Jesus. Jesus is passing by. He's here this morning. Jesus is here this morning. He's here to visit you. He's here to touch you. He's here to make impossible to become possible. I don't care what the doctor must have said. All I know is that Jesus is here. All I know is that Jesus will touch you. All I know is that Jesus will change your situation. All I know is that you will not remain the same. At the end of this service today, Jesus will touch you. He will. He will. Call upon that name. The name that every name mortal. The name that is greater than any other name. It's not the name of Dickie Osho. It's not the name of Dickie Ejike. It's not the name of our Sanko. It's the name that is higher than any other name. That name, Jesus. Call upon that name. Tell him to help you. Tell him to remember you. Tell him to show you mercy. Tell him to favor you. Please call upon him. I beg you, call upon him. Jesus is here. He is here. He's passing by. He's here. Choir, I need you on the altar. We're going to sing that song. Jesus is here. He's here to touch you. He's here to change your situation. He's here to turn your situation around. Jesus is here right now. He's in this auditorium. The angels are distributing blessings. The angels are touching people. Jesus is here. Holy Ghost is here. I don't care. Jesus is here right now. He's here to be at the point of your knee. Brother, pray it in. Tell that situation. You must give way. You must give way. That situation in your life, they must give way. Jesus is here right now. Choir.
Jesus
is here right now.
Is here.
Jesus is here. He is here. Jesus is here.
Jesus.
He's here.
Is here.
Jesus, he's here right now. Jesus, he's here right now. Jesus, he's here.
are your maker. My Savior, please remember, oh God. You've not sent us in vain. You've sent us to do your work. You've sent me to preach your word today. Oh, remember your work, oh God. Please, Lord. Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Oh God, how wonderful you are. It's just too good, you're marvelous. You are wonderful, you are glorious, you are unchangeable. You are the lily of the valley, the bright and the morning star, the captain of our soul, the cruise controller of our life, the savior of our life, the director of our situation. We thank you, we bless you, we exalt you. How glorious you are. You are glorious in power, you are glorious in all things. You have never changed. You are God of yesterday, you are the God of today, you are the God of tomorrow. You know our situation. You are making a way. You are solving it for us. Oh, we thank you. We just exalt you. We just praise you. Thank you for what you have done today. Thank you for what you are going to do. Thank you for what you are doing. Thank you for what you are taking us to. We worship you. We exalt you. This morning, all we have done is to lift you up. And you said that if I be lifted up, you will draw all men closer to your side. My Father, these are your children, including myself. All we have done is to lift you up. I pray that heaven will answer us. My God, my Father, this morning I cry to you. I ask you for one thing. That we do impossible things.
Amen.
What seems impossible in the life of all these your children, I ask you to make a way for them.
Amen.
Father, this morning, answer your word.
Amen.
Make a way for your people.
Amen.
As we end this month of November, every man that is saying amen, I pray for you and your family. You will have a testimony. As God lives, the God that we serve in this mission, under His grace we tap into, that as the Lord liveth, your testimony will be great. Whoever is looking for your downfall, Lord, you will put them to shame. My God, my Father, in the month of December, I pray for everyone that is here. You will have a testimony.
Amen.
God will put a testimony in your mouth.
Amen.
Thank you, my Savior. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Can we give a clap to the Almighty? Let's appreciate God. Appreciate God. It's not any man. It's just God alone and alone and alone. I want you to look at the brother or the sister by your side and say, congratulations. Congratulations, my sister. Congratulations, my brother. Because you will testify. Please be seated. God bless you. God bless you. Actually, I have to control myself because I was just telling Daddy, I said, God, Daddy, please, let's still have 5 minutes more. Let's have 5 minutes more. I just feel like we should just continue to pray till the service is over. Even though yesterday I was preparing the message, I had about four pages and that I reduced the 4 pages to 2 pages because I got the inclination from the spirit within me that let my people pray. This morning I felt, okay, I'll come, we'll talk about the message, and then after that we will go into the section of prayer. But Daddy said, no, let my people pray. And I said, okay, fine. When we, the ministers, we were at the back, I told them one thing. I said, I beg you this morning. I asked them. I said, because God is set to do something here this morning. I never know it will be this way. I just told them at the back. I said, but please, back me up with prayer. Back me up in prayer. I begged them this morning. And when we came here, I can feel the Spirit moving in a great way. That whatever might be the situation, God is able to turn it around. I don't want you to give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. The richest man, the richest man, the richest man in Saudi Arabia, he fell 19 times until he was with just one Saudi riyal. He kept on bouncing, bouncing, bouncing. He borrowed money from his friend. He kept on bouncing back. So God has come to tell you. He has asked me to tell you this morning, don't give up. Don't give up. Don't. Maybe you are thinking, you are here this morning, you left house. You say, let me just go to church. And you've come, you are very sad when you enter. You feel all hope is gone. Maybe at home, your husband, your wife, things are not looking fine. And you just feel like, I want to give up this marriage. I want to go back. I want to leave Dubai. Because things are looking so tough. God has sent me to you this morning to tell you, don't give up. Keep on. He will make a way. Amen. I said he will make a way. Amen. That's the God that we serve. I've not come this morning, I said, Gabriel will make a way. I've not come this morning, I said, Angel Michael will make a way. But I have come to tell you the name that is above every name that is able to change your situation. That name that is called Jesus, he will make a way for you. Yeah. I said he will make a way for you. Please, hold on to him. Be on his side. Don't make you to change. Don't look for a shortcut. Don't look for alternative. Just stand. Hold on. And say, God, you will make a way for me. No matter, you will make a way for me. So I implore you. I beg you this morning, because I have come to you, all in the name of Jesus, who have sent me. And I know that name. How many of you know that name? Can I hear you call that name?
Jesus!
Call that name for the defeat of the enemy.
Jesus!
Rise up and call that name.
Jesus!
What is that name?
Jesus!
The name that is above every other name.
Jesus!
The name that can change your situation. Please be seated. That is the name I'm talking about. That name, Jesus. I am a witness of it. People say, oh, they are pastor. They pass. They don't know. They are okay. No, we are human. But I have come to tell you this morning that no matter your situation, no matter what you are going through, as long as you are a child of God, he will fight on your behalf.
Amen.
He will make a way for you.
Amen.
Don't give up. Don't worry about what people may say. Don't worry about that situation. I tell you this morning, I am a witness. I'm telling you boldly, with confidence, that is in me, that if you stand with God, he will make a way.
Amen.
It might look that the situation is not palatable. It might look the situation is so difficult. He will make a way. He will turn the situation around. He has a solution ready. He's a master solution provider. That's what I call him. A master solution provider. He has a plan for you. All you need to do, just stand by his side. I have a friend. He used to say, Pastor Osho, I am under the cruise of the Holy Spirit. When you put on the cruise control, what do? You remove your leg from the pedal, and what happens? You just keep going. Am I right? That is where you should be. When you are in the side of God, let just the Holy Spirit, let him just keep on flowing. Let him keep on driving. I tell you, you will arrive safely. Can I hear a big amen? Our father has told me that we should talk about prayer and fasting this morning. Because we are hanging our fasting and prayer. But I only have 10 minutes. I like to keep to time. I don't preach for 1 hour, 2 hours. I keep to time. Because what God wants to do, he has already done it. Amen.
Amen.
If you want God to turn your life around, there are two keys that must characterize your lifestyle. Two keys. It must be part of your lifestyle. It must be something that you desire to do without any demand from the pastor or from minister. And that is why I want to talk about it very briefly. Prayer and fasting. You must be a man and a woman of prayer if you want God to move. If you want God to change your situation, you must discipline your body. Discipline yourself to wait upon God. I'm not here this morning to boast to you, to tell you what I want to say. But I'm here to tell you, to encourage you as a Christian, as a child of God, that we are on the same pilgrimage to heaven. Our Father in the Lord, like I said 2 weeks ago, last week, by the grace of God, I was in another parish. One of our former pastor here, I went to preach in his parish last week Friday, Pastor Vitayo, I was there. And our pastor was also posted to another place because we had they move us from one place to another to preach. It was glorious. It was fantastic. My choir, there is one of my sister there. You are there also, right? Where is she? Can I see your hand? Is she there or she's at the bar? You know, she was there last week Friday. We had a wonderful time in that parish. God moved like ever before. And that is why I have a confidence this morning that God, he has already started to do something in somebody's life. And we will testify in Jesus' name. So if you want God to be on your side, you must have time to pray, like I said. You must discipline your body as a Christian. Over 15 years or 14 years now, every Wednesday, I wait upon God. Just for my own personal spiritual life. You must do the same. Have a time a day that you desire, you take away food, you take away everything, you wait upon God. It will help you. One day of the week, just one day, that you will use it to pray and to fast. That one day, you will call your wife and children together and tell them we have to fast, we have to pray. Just one day. My children, they go to school, and where they live is a country that they have law and order. Because if they don't bring their food to school, the teacher will ask them, where are your food packed? But whenever they are waiting upon God, we have to write a letter to the school that today they are waiting upon God. As far as they are, they cannot go to 6 o'clock, but they wait in a certain time till 12 o'clock. And my son will say, Daddy, can we eat after 12? I say, yes, you can eat. We building them all as small as they are. So also as you, as a Christian, you must discipline yourself. yourself. If you want to walk with God, you must sacrifice something. Then he said to Aaron, that I will not give anything that does not do what? Cost me. Something must cost you. In order to serve God, you forsake the world and you're on the Lord's side. So I encourage you this morning, let it be your lifestyle. We're going to be finishing the fasting tomorrow. For those who are still doing the 30 days, for those who have done something, they've already finished. But those who are going to finish tomorrow, don't let just be that week after tomorrow, we start eating. You forget that, don't wait till daddy proclaim again another 30 days. Let it be something that you do on a daily basis. Why do we fast? Let's look at very quickly because I don't have time. Mark chapter 2, I'm going to read very quickly. Mark chapter 2, can you please help us project it? Mark chapter 2 verse 18 to 20. Mark. And the disciple of John and of the Pharisees used to fast. And they came and said unto him, why did the disciple fast of John and of the Pharisees fast? But the disciple fast not. Next verse, please. And Jesus said unto them, can the children of the what? Bride chamber fast while the bridegroom is with them? As long as they have what? The bridegroom with them. They cannot do what? They cannot fast. Next one, please. But the day will come when the bridegroom shall do what? He shall be taken away from them. And what will they do? And they shall fast in what? In those days. That's why. Christ is gone. Here we are now. What we need to make it to be our lifestyle. We need to wait. We need to fast. Why do we fast? We fast in obedience to Jesus' teaching. Matthew chapter 6, verse 16 to 18. We fast to demonstrate our dependency on God. James chapter 4, verse 10. We fast to demonstrate repentance from sin. Jonah chapter 3, verse 5 to 10. We fast to receive God's wisdom and direction. Acts chapter 13, verse 1 to 3. We fast to receive deliverance in time of crisis. 2 Chronicles chapter 20. We fast to humble our soul before God. Psalm 35, verse 13. We fast to seek the Lord. Daniel chapter 9, verse 3. We fast to generate spiritual power in our inner mind. That is why we fast. We fast to do that. Mark chapter 9, verse 29. We fast to seek intervention against the enemy that is oppressing us. 2 Samuel chapter 12, verse 16 to 19. We fast to seek direction even for our family. Ezra chapter 8, verse 21. And finally, we fast to seek favor among men. Esther chapter 4, verse 16. For us as a Christian to experience revival, our lives must be revisited with practical spiritual discipline of prayer and fasting. There is a link between revival and prayer and fasting. If you want God to touch your life, to make a change in your life, you must be somebody that is dedicated to prayer and fasting. The Bible passage also revealed to us that in order for us to fast, to receive from God, there are blessings to why we fast. It helps us as a Christian when we fast, when we commune with God. It gives us focus. When I'm fasting to God, I have focus. In my office, as a Christian, they must know who you are. When I join my company, I tell to the team board, on Tuesday, on Wednesday, don't give me tea, don't give me coffee, don't give me anything. And I said to him, 6 o'clock is when I break my fasting. Immediately, 6 o'clock, he will come with, I don't drink tea or coffee, I drink Milo. Amen. I'm still a little boy, okay? And he will bring the Milo to my office by 6 o'clock, and he will put it on my table by my side. I say, thank you, sir. They must know who you are. They must know that you are a Christian. You are a child of God who is dedicated. dedicated to God, not somebody that is playing panky-panky or playing game in the office. You must be very straight and let them know whom you stand for. When you declare God, God is glorified. You say, that's my son. Yes, that's my daughter. Yes, it's showing forth of him that is in him. Because you must make time to wait upon God. And as you do that, the Lord will answer you in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Finally, brethren, godly prayer with fasting, it releases spiritual breakthrough. Godly prayer with fasting, make a way and quench enemy and make you to enter into the throne of grace. Godly prayer with fasting. When you fast, you back it up with prayer. You receive spiritual power that comes from, you don't even know where it comes from. A dynamite, a kind of grace will fall upon you when you do it in a godly way. When you wait upon God spiritually, when you wait upon Him with fasting. I finish by what I said earlier on Numbers chapter 23. I'm sure some of us know it. And we are going to take this verse of the scripture to God. Numbers chapter 23. Please, technical. Numbers chapter 23. Give me verse 19. God is not a man that he should do what? He should lie. Neither the son of man that he should do what? He should repent. Has he said it? Shall he not do it? Has he spoken? Shall he not make it? Can I hear a big amen?
Amen.
Before we go to prayer, I'm asking you a question. Are you on the Lord's side?
Yes, sir.
If you are not born again, I challenge you this morning. Come on inside. Forget about all this game. Don't worry about your situation. God is ready to make it good. All he's asking is that my son come to me. My daughter, give your life to me.
All these things that look so beautiful that you are running after, I have them in my household. I have a Lord. I will help you only if you can surrender to me. How many times that you will, if you are on the Lord's side,
God will speak to you when you don't even expect. If you are on the Lord's side, He will talk to you. He will direct your path and make a way for you. The Bible says, God is not a man that he will lie. He will never lie. Whatever he has said, he's able to do it. Whatever he has promised, he's able to bring it to pass. All he's asking you is, give your life to me. Surrender everything to me. I'm ready to make it good. All is bow, all eyes closed. Before we go into the next section of prayer, I want you to commit your life to God. All eyes bow, all eyes closed. You know you are not born again, my brother, my sister. Don't feel shy about it. God wants to turn your life around. He wants to change your situation. All he's asking you this morning is to surrender yourself to me. Give your life to me. I will change your situation. Can I see your answer? You want to tell him, I say, today, Lord, I want to give my life to you. Raise it up properly. Don't be shy. Raise it up. All eyes closed. Don't look at anybody. Just raise it up. Raise it up properly. Don't be shy. Tell him and say, Jesus, I want to surrender all unto you. I'm tired. I want to be your son and daughter. God, give me that grace. Raise it properly. Raise it properly. Tell him and say, God, today, Lord, have mercy on me. I confess my sin. Tell him about all those things. I tell him to come into your life. Tell him to make you sons and daughter. That from today, you will not go back to any sin anymore. Father, I want to thank you for all these hands that I raise up unto you, not to any man, to anybody, but unto you alone. I pray for them. Father, receive them today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As they've made up their mind to serve you till the end, grant them the grace never to go back in the name of Jesus. Amen. The boldness they need, to continue to follow you until they make it to heaven. Father, give to them from today in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Can I hear a big amen?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. How many of you have been blessed? Have you been blessed? All those hands, I want you to stand up. Those hands, please go to the back. One of our ushers is waiting at the back. Go and see them at the back. Give them that paper and they will help you. Shall we all rise up? Let's all rise up. Let's all rise up. We're going to pray only one prayer. We're going to hold just one prayer. Hold that sister. Let's form a prayer shape. A very long prayer shape. Hold the brother. Hold the sister. All by your side. Let's hold one another. Hold one another. Hold one another. Hold one another. We're going to pray this prayer. I say, my Father.
My Father.
My Father. This brother that I'm holding. This sister that I'm holding, God will favor you. Pray that prayer for me. Pray that prayer. Pray that prayer. God will favor you. Whatever the situation you are going through, the God that we serve, they will favor you. God will favor you. The mercy of God will favor you. He will remember you for good. Pray for that brother. Pray for that sister. Let's pray for one another. God will favor you. God will remember that brother. He will remember that sister. We pray.
Amen.
My Father, the maker of heaven and earth, I proclaim your word to every life that is in this hall this morning, that as you live, you will make a way for them.
Amen.
Whatever the challenges that they are going through, I pray, let there be a solution.
Amen.
Where they have been disappointed, Lord, let them recover.
Amen.
Make a way for them.
Amen.
Your word has said, you are not a man that will lie. Whatever you have said, you will do it. Father, everything that they are trusting in you for, Father, make a way for them.
Amen.
Answer them, oh God.
Amen.
Put laughter in their mouth.
Amen.
That by the time we will be giving testimony in the month of December, they will have a testimony to give. Mercy, it will follow you.
Amen.
You will end this year well.
Amen.
You will not cry.
Amen.
Testimony will pursue you.
Amen.
Testimony will sleep with you. Favor will overshadow you. Favor will envelop you.
Amen.
And we will make it to heaven.
Amen.
Thank you, our Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Let's give a clap to the Almighty. Let's bless you.